Yeah! Wow, a lot of excitement with that song. You never get tired of the excitement.
It gets you up, doesn't it?
It gets you going. I mean, I was half asleep, and now I'm all charged up. Right? I love when Benji screams in it. Scream some more. All right. For the last 2 years of my life, I've been involved in a project that has taken up almost every weekend, every vacation that we've been on. And this is something I vowed I would never do again. But yes, Howard Stern has written a new book.
Woo!
I have written a new book. My third book. And Robin, I swear to you, it was torture.
I know it was torture. You would tell me how tortured you were. I didn't know what about.
And I will now reveal the new cover to you.
Ooh, ooh. We have the
and
cover
and the title. Yes. Excuse me.
That's exciting.
There you go, Robin.
All right.
See the title?
Whoa. Whoa. Let me see. I can't. Comes again.
Howard Stern comes again. Howard Stern comes again.
Very nice picture.
That is me looking pensive as an author, as a serious author. What happened was I never wanted to write another book. And then, and over the years, I've been pitched by a lot of publishing companies.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. You've turned down a lot of offers.
Because the success of the other two books. The other two books, if you remember, were crazy. They sold out in 5 minutes. It comes out officially May 14th.
So you could pre-order right now.
Pre-order right now. And therefore, you would have the perfect Father's Day gift, because that made sense to me, because we know a lot of dads like me. But I predict the wives will like this book.
Really?
Because this is about my evolution. And this is about my interviews. And this is a book of, this is what started out. I was going to put out a book of my favorite interviews that I've done. Then I said, I can't just put out a book of interviews. I've got to now comment on them and tell you why these were good. Then I said, well, now I've got to talk about that we move from SiriusXM. So I started talking about the process. And I started talking about my life and some of the things that have happened. I really think this is the capper to my career. After this, I can...
You're not writing another book?
Nah. Oh.
Oh, come on.
I can tell you for sure. My excitement is that for 20 years, I said I wouldn't write a book.
Yeah.
And even my wife said, you know, I thought you vowed you would never write again with, you know, your summers and this and that. And then inevitably it happens. I really thought I had it figured out that I wouldn't have to give up a summer, but
this
I gave up two.
This was going to be an easy one, right?
This is what I love about it. It's the summer. Everyone is already saying, Robin, within 10 minutes, it's the summer read.
It's the read, yeah.
Writing a book is not about just writing the book. That was difficult enough for me. The hard part now is with this promotion.
I came up with a Times Square billboard because I assume you're going to have a Times Square billboard.
All right, okay. I don't assume anything, but go ahead.
I have a concept for it that I brought in.
Let me see it.
To show you. Can I show you it?
Oh,
all
right.
Okay.
I have a storyboard.
Hey, we've got visual aids.
Oh, boy.
Will you actually like try and have an open mind about this and not immediately shit on it, Robin?
I have an open mind.
Go ahead.
Okay.
Let me see your
for
idea.
The first time ever.
Wow.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
Now, when you see it at first, you might think, oh, well, what's so great about that?
Just show it to me.
Okay. Imagine this like 20 floors high in Times Square, all right?
All right.
Okay. So this is what it's going to look like. And obviously, it'll be a real picture. But it's you. You're lying in your bed at home.
Right. This is a billboard?
It's a billboard. Imagine it's like 20 floors high.
All right, go ahead.
You're lying in bed naked.
You got to see this on the app. Yeah, go ahead.
You're lying
right
in bed
now,
naked.
Come
in.
Naked?
You're jerking off.
Oh, my God.
And you're smiling.
And you're smiling.
Are you for real or is this a bit?
No, I swear to God. This...
Wait a second. How many billboards have you seen in Times Square of a guy jerking off? Are you fucking high?
It's implied jerking off because you can't see your
implied
hand. It's behind the book.
They're not going to put that up in
Howard, you're not
Square.
Keeping an open mind about
this.
Wait a minute. Let's let him explain
There are so many layers to this billboard.
Right. I was excited about the billboard.
There are so many layers to this billboard.
Keep going.
Okay, so the point is, like, now you're this, like, evolved family man. So I put the picture of your, like, cat Walter. You got Beth watching you jerking off. And then, like, your blind cat is in bed with you while you're jerking off.
Yeah.
You have the book covering your junk so no one's offended by it. And you have a big smile on your
face. Is he for real?
1,000%.
I'm going to tell you something.
Is that a problem?
The other day, I had an interaction with you in here.
Yeah.
I was so impressed with you. I was like, you know, this fucking guy is talented.
Yes.
I don't know if you're for real or not.
I think this is a joke.
This is the same thing you did with the Super Bowl commercial. Like, yes, a billboard of my book would be fabulous in Times Square.
Yeah.
Now think about it. I want to reach people.
Yes.
Just listen to me.
Go ahead.
I want to reach people who maybe don't realize this is a really good book, in my opinion. Like something really, really, really meaty and really good to read.
Yeah. And you've also talked about how this is an evolution.
And I'm trying to reach people who maybe are turned off to me. They see a picture of me in bed jerking. It's provided that even in Times Square, the guy who owns the billboard is willing to put a guy jerking off in the bed, implied jerking off.
You haven't
off.
Even let me finish.
Okay. To a blind.
Howard, I would say.
There's a bottle of room.
There is more to this billboard than what you're looking at.
Yeah. Yes.
Might change your mind.
Like, do you remember how Dave Letterman used to like squirt water on people as they walked by the Sullivan Theater?
Oh, now he's going to be squirting.
Jesus Christ.
This is the surprise. People are in Times Square,
yes.
Right? And they're walking by,
right.
Like families, and every hour on the hour, it'll just be like...
He's full of it.
Oh.
And it goes, and it cheers his fake cheers.
This is a goof.
All over, like the family.
At least you saved the best part.
I'm with Mehmet on this. That's fucking great.
Yeah, you know what, though? Here's the point.
Everyone will go
it's
to get cheers done by
you know
the family.
Legally,
you
not,
know what,
he's
Howard?
Polish.
We work he's here not. At SiriusXM. They wouldn't put that in the lobby.
Come on.
No way.
You know, and he wants to put it in a billboard in Times Square. His family's coming by and getting jizzed on.
I'm in a Bukkake tourist.
I've looked into this. MIT has like facial recognition technology.
Sit down. Now you're being silly.
You're so funny, my man.
What a pity.
You know that would be cool.
You're so funny.
You know that would be
you're
cool.
You're so funny.
Okay.
All right. What you don't understand is...
Oh, go wash yourself.
A guy coming on people...
It's implied cum. It's just shaving cream.
Yeah, but you don't understand. I don't know.
Things on people.
Why was it okay for Letterman to squirt on people?
But the New York Times. But it wasn't coming out of his dick. His implied dick.
It's coming out of the book that's covering your junk. You come every hour in Times Square.
All right. Okay.
I got to get out of this country.
I got to get out of this conversation at least. Anybody following that R. Kelly story like I am?
Oh, yeah.
That Gayle King interview is real good. Gayle's all calm.
She was amazing.
How can I work? How can I get paid? How can I take care of my kids? How?
Your ex-wife.
Sounds like a good song.
Can we get some music?
Here's the deal. Here's
sure.
The deal. I'm just being honest.
I don't know how to hog that, people. What would I hog that? You don't want to believe it. How? How can I pay child support? How? How can I work? How? How can I get paid? This ain't not about music.
Point, we briefly pause the interview to give Kelly a moment.
You asked for it, you got it. Put a little music, and you got the new R. Kelly mix.
That's pretty good.
Hey, by the way, I've decided my first real interview that I give about this new book, Howard Stern Comes Again, will be to Alex Jones.
What?
Yes. Alex Jones put in the request.
Why are you doing that for Alex Jones?
I'm going to do it right here this morning. He's on satellite.
Prepare to discard your mental blinders. Infowars.com.
Wow.
Infowars.com. I am on with known degenerate globalist Howard Stern, Prince of the Prime Controllers, sociopathic congenital liar, constantly tells people, let NAMBLA in your schools. Good morning, Howard.
Listen, I never said let NAMBLA in your schools. That's ridiculous. You're making up things, but I decided to give you the first interview on my book, Howard Stern Comes Again. And by the way, this is great with the satellite. I can see you.
Absolutely. It's a beautiful studio we have here. We are listener funded. We are not Soros funded like you. This is what we have. Listen, I said I don't want to talk to a globalist, but you know what? The eagle doesn't hunt the flea. You are a fellow author. As you know, I wrote 9/11, Descent into Tyranny, The New World Order's Dark Plans to Turn Earth into a Prison Planet.
Who published that?
I would
that?
Have you on. Everybody published it. That's who.
That's right. Robin.
Don't question me.
By the way, I see many items on your desk. I've never actually seen your studio before. You got a lot of products. Are those products you personally use?
These are products I use, my family uses. I endorse these wholeheartedly, Howard. Infowars.com, prisonplanet.tv. You'll get the products. But listen, I got you on.
Right.
Tell us about your piece of propaganda trash book. Go ahead. Come on.
All right. Well, I've written a new book. Howard Stern Comes Again.
Hold on one second. I'm going to mock you with a puppet while you speak. Don't mind me. Keep going.
Come on.
That's your Howard puppet?
That looks like me, doesn't it?
Hold on. The Howard puppet wants to say something.
Go ahead.
Hey, now, read my book and don't question the government's accelerated immunogenics program, Robin. Oh, thank you, Howard puppet.
I didn't know you had a Howard puppet.
I do now. Listen.
Well, I should sue you because people think that's really me.
Well, I should sue you for going on about the standardized total surveillance, control grid, the breakaway civilizations. Listen, I respect you as a broadcaster. I respect your interviews. One of my favorite interviews you ever did. Do you remember this? In 1996, you had Hillary Clinton on your show, and you both talked about being members of the reptilian elite. Do you remember that?
No.
No, I don't, actually. I wish I would have had her on. I couldn't get her on.
You don't believe me? Here, roll the clip. Check it out. You'll see.
Okay.
All right. Hey, now. My best friend, Hillary Clinton, is here.
I'm Hillary Clinton. I'm a reptilian leader.
So am I. Hey, now.
I'm a terrible reptile with AIDS. I want to kill and eat a team of Navy SEALs.
Hey, now. You've said it all. There you go. Your interviews are a lot shorter on K-Rock. You really have evolved.
Yes. I got to tell you, Alex, this is an honor for you because I have not given any interviews yet on the book, and you're the first one. So I did it because I felt, look, you're a broadcaster. You've been banned from everywhere.
Yes.
You can't find your show anywhere.
And listen, the corporate media, they strangle free speech. They strangle America. The gatekeepers say, read our talking points. We'll give you administrative control. We'll let you not be one of the proletariat slaves like Jones, but you understand me, and I appreciate that. Listen, Roger Stone's coming in the next hour. Howard, I'm going to let you go. Here, plug your globalist trash book before
all
you
right,
leave. Go.
Thank you for that. For your audience, I think you guys will really love the book. Howard Stern Comes Again. I hope everybody buys it and enjoys it.
Are there any conspiracies in it?
There are, actually.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I think Alex will approve. And
do you talk about the mass farming of humanoid tissue, cows that produce human milk, spiders that produce body armor, human-animal embryos, and how they kill them on the embryonic level before they're grown fully?
I don't talk about that, but I think you can learn something from the book. Look, you're a broadcaster. I talk about my methods and the way I broadcast, and I choose my favorite interviews, and I show them. There's a very sweet picture of me on the cover. Howard Stern Comes Again, Alex.
Yeah,
was
you
the picture
must have
taken at the Bilderberg
it.
Meeting?
What is that?
Was it taken at the Bilderberg meeting when you go and you hang out with Bill Gates and you talk about disease X?
Oh, boy.
As a matter of fact, that's where we shot the picture. You're right.
Beautiful. Listen, you've been a good guest. I tell you what, Howard. I'm not going to leave you empty-handed. I'm going to send you home with some InfoWars products.
Please.
You're going to love your 9/11 hoodie footy. With thermal technology, it'll keep you warm because coziness is an inside job. Also, you're getting Super Male Shield Vitality. It's got some good allergens, got some bad allergens, made with red yeast rice. You're going to have energy. You're going to have burning urine. You're going to love it. InfoWars.com.
All right. Well, thank you, Alex, for allowing me on your show.
Is burning urine a good thing?
Yeah, you know, you want that if you want to be macho like Alex. All right, Alex, thank you.
InfoWars.com. Free Roger Stone.
InfoWars.com. InfoWars.
I love the Howard Puffer.
All right. Thank you.
Goodbye, Alex.
Goodbye, Alex. Gary was explaining to me when Benji comes into his office to use the microphone when he gets on air finally. he was describing how disgusting it is because Benji's belly is.
So Benji wears an untucked shirt, not an untucked shirt, just an untucked shirt.
Just an untucked shirt.
And his belly rests on my lap. And sometimes he stays.
Why? What is it? The microphone is on your desk, right?
Right. So I hold the button because I don't trust Benji to leave. Like, I have to control the button.
Right.
Otherwise,
because if he gets the button, he'll never get off.
Right. He'll never get off the button. And then he, like, when he gets more agitated, he leans in further. It's almost like his belly's fucking me.
How much of, like, where is his belly hitting you? I thought on your shoulder.
It's hits me on my thigh.
Really?
Yeah.
And it's such a belly.
It is. There's a lot going on
it's
there.
It's a gunt.
Oh, it's a gunt.
And it peeks out of the bottom of the shirt, too. Like, the shirt doesn't cover it.
A little cleavage.
little belly cleavage.
And it's weird. It's like a Gary eclipse, because Gary completely disappears.
I know. When he took over, all I could see was a bit of Gary's pink shirt.
It's true. Watch Gary. Like, Gary, and Gary's, like, pushing back against that belly.
I'm actually trying to get around him, and you see my head pokes out once in a while, like a crescent moon.
Like, he's on top of you.
Yeah,
like,
you've been eclipsed.
It's like he's banging you. Does he smell, or is he?
He smells fine.
He smells fine?
It's fine. It's just like, it really is, he really is in my personal space in a big way.
I wouldn't even want to be that close to Benji. It's weird.
Yeah, but he's got to stay with that button.
No, he has to.
I got a job.
Hey, Howard. Are you there? I rescued a bird yesterday. I was inspired, but I really did.
Benji leave do 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 do. Benji leave do 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 do. Benji leave do 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 do. Benji leave.
I got Ronnie fired up this morning.
What'd you bring up?
Well, I was walking in and I see JD, right?
Yeah.
So I say to Ronnie, look at this guy. And like JD can't even hear us. He's working.
Uh-huh.
And Ronnie goes, what do you mean? I go, big shot now. He goes, yeah, big shot. He just gets crazy if I get him nuts.
All you have to do is say the right word.
Yeah, I go, yeah, he's a big shot now. I go, with all his fancy meals and his wine and his fucking sculpture he's taking picture of. He goes, yeah, he thinks he's too good for us.
Oh, no. You know, that's Ronnie's big thing. Don't change.
Yeah, and I go, JD's too good for us, man. Fuck him. And he goes, yeah, fuck him.
Yeah, fuck him with a big dildo in his intellectual ass.
Like, I started a fight and JD didn't even know what was going
on. Right, JD hasn't done anything.
Yeah, Ronnie was all pissed off. I could get him fired up in 2 seconds. And where's my JD puppet? Let me get that involved here.
Where is it? Don't hide that thing and don't mistreat it. We want it to last.
Meanwhile, JD goes, I have that exact shirt. I go, I know you do. And the one he's wearing today kind of looks like this.
Yeah, we patterned this after you.
And this is one of my suits. Actual size.
I don't know.
Yeah, you think you're so smart, I'll shove a wine bottle up your ass.
I didn't say anything. I just went to, like, one sculpture.
Yeah, you got to stay co-magnon like me.
What was the sculpture, JD?
Whatever. She told me to, take a picture and...
Was it on social media?
Whatever. Fuck it. Whatever.
So you put your sculpture on social media?
I took one picture, and she said, just take a picture and
spit it out, moron! Come on!
I'm getting out of here. Come on.
Did the sculpture have tits?
No.
Did it have a twat? Then what good is it, you fucker?
Yeah, why would you take a picture of that?
I don't know. How am I doing, JD, with your puppet? Where is that maniac?
You're doing wonderful.
Look, we almost have... do we have, like, the same shirt on?
They're identical.
I heard a rumor you and your wife are hanging out with a black couple this weekend for potential swinging. Is that true?
Yes.
And you are going to swing with them when?
Probably in a couple of weeks.
Like it's all set.
Yeah, it's all set.
Oh,
we went out for drinks, and then we went to this place that has dancing and a DJ. And then we ended up at the end of the night standing out on a street corner in Jersey City. the two girls made out, then I made out with the girl, and she made out with the guy. There was this guy standing there looking like, what the fuck is going on here?
I wow. thought Brent was going to say he made out with the guy.
I did.
That's what you were hoping for.
People have seen pictures of this couple that you have shown around the office. And
Just a shuly. So, but,
I see. Yeah. So this
is
a big deal.
You might as well show it to everybody.
Does the guy have a big pecker?
I have no idea.
Like, Shirley said the guy's enormous. I don't know what that means.
I saw pictures of this couple, and I think Brent's completely out of his element. I think this guy, I think his wife's leaving him, and the three of them are going to start a new thing somewhere.
No, well, Shirley's completely wrong.
This guy looks like he could break both of them in half, Brent and really? His wife.
So, and you're telling me when this guy is fucking your wife, probably has a nice big cock.
15-incher.
Yeah. You're not going to get crazy?
No.
Wow. Ben, you are a swinger.
Well, I'm not telling swings.
Yeah, he hasn't done it yet.
Well, he's all set up for it.
He's making ass.
This time
But he doesn't know what his reaction is going to be really until it happens.
Robin, I'm not completely inexperienced in this
That's
area.
That's not the point. This is a new experience.
Ish.
When you meet up, are you pretending like you're not about to fuck the guy's wife? Is there small talk for a while before you get into it?
No. That's the beauty of this, is you're not pretending that you're not going to fuck the guy's wife. I'm talking to this guy about what she likes and what, you know, we're...
But then how isn't the deal closed if everybody knows what they're there for? Like, they'd always end on a makeout. It never goes past that.
English, motherfucker, do you speak it? It takes some time to get her comfortable.
Why isn't there a second makeout after the first makeout?
What you're saying is that Brent has never successfully
Think he's the factor. I think he's the X factor.
Really?
I think he creeps him out. I think he's the stick in the fucking wheel.
You have no idea what you're talking about.
What's he saying, Brent, about you? He's saying you're a creep.
I've been around him fucked up, right, with a good buzz. Like, he gets a stare on him.
That's true.
Scary. Right?
That
Am
is
I
true.
Lying?
Right.
He gets a stare on him that you're like, I'm not going anywhere
so you're
near
saying,
this fucking
I mean, I know his wife's attractive. Guys want to fuck her.
Sure.
So it's true. It must be Brent that's scaring away all these swingers.
Well, how is this so difficult?
Well, I do want to see Brent dance. I can't even imagine Brent
Are you a good dancer?
Good would be stretching it.
I've been out with them, Howard. I've never seen Brent dance. Caitlin does all
Let's
the dancing.
Let's see it right now. Put on a song, Fred.
No. We got a song. Listen to this.
I'm definitely not doing it without being buzzed.
Come on,
and without,
get down.
Without checking.
You're saying dancing. You can dance and it doesn't look bad.
Good enough to get by.
Right.
It's a lot of grinding on the chick more than dancing.
There you go.
Dance with Shirley.
Dance with Shirley.
We're going to dance to Judas Priest.
Grind on his butt.
He had a chance to swing. He didn't fucking close the deal.
Wow.
How about into twinks?
Are you going?
Shirley was twerking for you.
The reality is, I think he wants it so badly that he's turning them off.
I think Shirley might have it wrong.
That's completely wrong. That is completely. You're just making shit up.
I have a question for Brent.
Go ahead.
No shit. Are you worried, like, what would happen if the guy jizzed and it got on you?
Oh, come on. That's not going to happen.
I mean, Richard's fantasizing over there.
No,
I mean,
I'm just saying.
Don't drag me into your sexual fantasies.
Are you prepared for that?
Are you prepared? It's probably not going to happen since we use condoms, so.
Right. Come on. You know, Shuly, you're standing in front of the poster of my new book.
How dare you?
No, I'm saying with my head of hair against Shuly's head, it looks like...
Oh, you think it's like Shuly has hair?
It looks like Shuly has hair. It's not a bad look for you, I'll be honest.
That hasn't been since 79.
I have to agree with Shuly that the process is getting late.
So that's not the process.
If you want a romance, you do what you did when you meet Caitlin. You have a long build up and you get involved with each other. Swinging is about not getting involved.
It's getting comfortable with the situation, Robin.
He's a swingless swinger right now, and he will eventually get his wings.
Hey, listen, I just got a new car recently, and I stumbled upon Sirius. And there's your voice. I haven't heard your voice in so long, maybe since the YSP days. And Howard, in 5 minutes, I was home. Just personally, I am so happy to listen to your bits. Fred Ronnie is the greatest character I've ever heard in my life. That is the funniest freaking thing I've ever heard.
Well, Fred has really found his home with
He's
the Ronnie.
He's blossomed, yeah.
He has really blossomed. It took a good, how many years? 40 years for Fred to blossom. But, I mean, the guy...
Hey.
And please, when you call in, if you just rediscovered us, less Fred, more about me, okay?
Yeah.
Now, there he is. Yay! Hey, look who it is.
Welcome back, buddy. How are you?
Fred Ronnie Bert is a fan of you.
Thank you, Bert. By the way, and your new book,
yes,
which is called Comes Again.
Yeah.
Is there anything about squirt?
Squirt, there's a chapter on squirt.
How about cock rings?
Cock rings, yes, of
dildos?
Course. Dildos, of course.
Pegging?
All right, come on.
NASCAR?
That's what you know.
Pussy?
That's your book.
Baby powder hand jobs? Anything but jerking off in your room with your parents having sex with a neighbor next door.
All right, listen, Bert, thank
Thanks,
you.
Bert.
Thanks for taking my call, and thank All right. you for everything.
All right, good to have you back, Bert. Very
hey,
good.
Bert, I got one question for Bert.
Go ahead.
Bert,
go ahead,
did you hear that I got fucked in the ass while you were gone?
He did. He got fucked in the ass by a girl wearing a dildo. Yeah.
We'll talk, Bert.
Yeah, there's a lot to learn if you've been away.
Yeah, you better get on Ronnie's social network.
See, the book will be good for Bert. He'll catch up on everything.
Gary thinks he's the king of trivia. Thinks he's better than me at trivia.
Well, what kind of trivia?
What trivia?
Trivial Pursuit, any of those games.
I think I could give you a run. I don't think I'm better than you at anything anymore. Because every contest we do on the air, I always lose.
I know. You know what you ought to do? You ought to get the Trivial Pursuit game. Let Robin pick five questions randomly.
Absolutely. I'll just reach in the thing and pull out anything.
I'll play you.
Play it like a game.
Right, that'd be fair.
You ask me a question, and let's say I get it.
Okay.
Then you ask him a new question.
Flunky.
And even if I get mine wrong, you ask him a fresh question.
Fine.
All right. And
he doesn't get to answer your question?
No.
Five questions, right?
Or you want to do it that way? You get to answer mine, or I get to answer yours?
Exactly. I think somebody should have the opportunity, because then you get to prove you know that.
You got a coin? Flip a coin for who goes first.
Call it in the air, Wolf.
Heads.
Heads it is.
All right, I'll go first.
You go first? All right.
I actually get to choose, because I have heads. I want Gary to go first.
Oh, very well. You give the toss to him.
Do I get to do it's any category?
Any category. Don't even judge the category. Just whatever your eye goes to.
Well, we should know what the category is.
You can know what it is when she announces it.
Right.
Okay.
Entertainment.
Okay.
What was the first talking motion picture with sound on the film?
That would be The Jazz Singer.
The answer is The Jazz Singer. He has
it. Wow. I didn't even know that. I thought it was like The Great Train Robbery, but I know it's a silent film. See, I do bad at this. I'm doomed. Is this mine now?
Yes.
All right, go ahead.
Well, wait a second. Maybe the contest should be somebody keeps going till they... Oh, no.
Okay. It's not a contest thing. Go ahead.
What type of betting is used in horse racing?
You mean there's a name for it?
Yes.
Like parlor betting?
There is a name for it.
All right, let me think. I know there's off-track betting.
How much time does he get?
I know there's... I'll go with parlor betting.
No.
What is it?
I can answer that, Robin.
Go ahead.
It's paramutual betting.
That's right.
Wow. You're good at this. I think I'm in trouble. I guess you're not that stupid.
Before I worked for you, when I was a real lonely guy, I swear to before I'd go to bed at night, I would just read the cards.
Really?
Instead of a book.
Is that how you knew that?
No. I just know that because my dad bets.
Oh. Yeah, my dad does too.
You mentioned that on the air one day. You did a whole rap about paramutual betting.
Yeah, but I didn't call it paramutual betting. I just called it betting.
You did.
Called it paramutual.
I don't retain. All right, that's 2-0, Baba Booey. You go, Baba Booey.
Noine.
Jeff Jarvis. Oh, Jeff. Jeff used to be the critic for TV Guide.
In an instant yesterday, without any media appearances, without any late night shows, without any of that, you became number one on Amazon. You have the power, my leash.
Well, thanks, Jeff. I'll tell you, I got to go out and promote this thing because I'm so proud of it. I just think people are going to love reading it.
Well, say a little bit more about what we're going to get.
Well, I told you yesterday what it started out was I started out writing a book about my interviews because I'm most proud of them. And I was just going to put out kind of like a coffee table book of the interviews. And then I said, well, let me write an intro and talk about my process, what I've been going through lately, what brought me to a new style and what it's been like to go to SiriusXM. So that's like the intro. Then I started writing about each of the people I feature in the book. Then I started to write about the interviews I couldn't get. So I made that into a chapter. Then I started cutting up interviews into little like snippets of things. And I started to write introductions to that. And then, so the thing evolved into this really nice read that I could see people this summer reading. And also it's a book I'm just super, super proud of.
I think we ought to spend some time trying to guess which was your absolute favorite interview.
I wonder if you know that, Robin. I bet you no one would be able to guess.
I don't think I'll be able to guess, but I want a hint. Like, is it a really famous person?
Yes.
Hmm.
I'm not going to tell you if you're right or wrong.
Okay.
I mean, eventually I will because I got to go out and promote the book. Yeah.
And was it in our serious time or?
It was during serious.
Okay. I think Madonna just keeps sticking in my head.
I'm not going to say.
Fred, who's the best interview?
McCartney.
Well, see, I was like, could it be McCartney?
That was pretty fucking important.
Important, but was it the best?
That's the thing.
I thought it was really good. In spite of the fact he's a Beatle, he's a legend, you held your cool.
Stephen Colbert was interesting for what he revealed.
Yes, but I'm going to say...
I also thought Letterman, but I'm not sure.
Can I guess,
Howard? Can I say for a second?
I don't know, Gary. I don't know if I want you guessing.
Okay.
Why not?
I want Gary to guess. Gary, guess. Go ahead.
I don't know.
If I'm
because he's privy to certain things that I was talking about. All right, go ahead.
Take I'm in that street.
What did you say?
I'll say this is more of an office vote. People seem to think that you're after your first Billy Joel interview that your style kind of changed a bit.
Interesting.
It was the way Howard bonded with Billy Joel in that first interview was pretty amazing.
Well, I don't want to say yet because I feel like that's something I can do a slow review. There's like a strip tease.
The Howard Stern Show.